today we will design the form of formwork are generally two kinds. First is horizontal formwork and second is the vertical formwork. If you will see the RCC building, horizontal formwork is where in slab and in beam. And second is the vertical formwork. Vertical formwork is used generally in column and second in retaining wall, RCC retaining wall. So now today we will design the formwork for the slab. You will see the slab section. Slab section, the topmost portion is the slab. In this portion, the thickness of the slab is given 150 mm. That is the thickness of the slab. After slab, the slab is rest on the ply, which is more than as sheeting. The thickness of the sheeting is given in the portion, that is 20 mm. After that, the load of this slab and sheeting is coming over the joist. The thickness of the joist, which is given in the portion, is 100 mm. After joist, stringer is provided, and the stringer size is given in the portion, it is 150 mm. This all load, that is the load of the slab, sheeting, joist and stringer, this all load is coming over the shore. This is the vertical support which we are providing in the RCC building by building the concrete. In general language, we say it as a prop. Vertical support, we say as a prop. So, it is also known by shore. This is the section of the shuttering work for the slab, and this is the plan. If you will see, this is the sheeting, and this red color is the joist. These are the different joists provided to support the sheeting. And this joint is supported over the stringer. This blue line is the stringer. And this is supported by the joist. Joist is, shore is shaped with a rectangular shape. Okay? Now the different data given in the portion, now we will start the solution. Before starting the solution or designing any member of the formwork, we must know the load which is coming over it. Okay? What are the different load which will come over the formwork? First of all, the dead load of the slab. Okay? The dead load of the slab, after that the light load, after that impact load and the self weight of the shuttering also. Because all this weight will come over the shuttering. Okay? So we must know what are the different types of the load which is coming. Dead load is the density of the concrete multiplied by thickness of the slab. Thickness of the slab which is given in the motion is the 150 mm. So we will multiply the density to the thickness of the slab. That is 20 mm multiplied by 0.5 which is 3.75 kilometer per meter square in the dead load. Light load directly given in the motion which is 3.5 kilometer per meter square. Impact load. Impact load, which load is this impact load? During doing the concreting, the impact of the labor, machinery, equipment, that load also occur on the formwork. So we have to assume that load also by designing the formwork for the slab. Okay. Impact load, which is given in the motion, is the 25% of the live load. 25% of the live load is given 3.5, so 25% of this. That is 0.25 multiplied by 3.5, that is 0.87 kilometer per meter square. Now the formwork load. Formwork load, we have to assume generally the formwork load is 0.7 kilometer. If we will take the example of 1 meter by 1 meter formwork, the load of this formwork is 0.7 kilometer, okay? Which is not given in the question, and we have assumed. Now the total load is what load? Dead load plus light load plus impact load plus formwork load, that is 8.825 kilonewton per meter square. This is the total load which we have to assume while designing the whole member of the formwork, that is stringer, joist or shore. Okay. Now we start with the designing of the sheeting. We will start with the designing of the sheeting. Span of sheeting is equal to span of joist. What we have to generally design, we have to find out the spacing of all these members, spacing of the joist, spacing of the stringer, and also we have to determine the spacing of the shore. Okay, so span of the sheeting is equal to span of the joist. Now these the different data is given in the portion. T is given, sigma b is given, tau is given, e is given. For this is given for every member, for either for the joist or shore or for the stringer. Now for finding the L, L means what? The spacing. We have to find the L spacing of this member. So for finding all this L, we have to use three formula. First, we have to use the bending moment formula. Second, we will use shear force formula, and then deflection formula. Out of all these formula, we will find out the length, and from these three, the minimum length we will take for the spacing of that member. So here the formula bending moment is equal to sigma y is equal to m divided by y. That is m is equal to sigma I by y. We can write this as a sigma into z, where z is equal to I by y. Now for simply supported beam, m is equal by lambda square by 8. Because this is a simply supported span. Okay, this simply supported beam or span. So we will take it as a m is equal to wn square by 8. Now wn square by 8 is equal to, this is m. M is for what? This here is given. Sigma by z. Okay, wn square divided by sigma into z. Where z is equal to I by y, we will find out the I. How we find out the I? That is b, bdq by 12. So here we get the value of I. Now we will find y. So I is equal to d by 2. What is d? D is the thickness of the taking, that is the thickness of the sheeting. 20 divided by 10 is the 10 mm. So we will put here in z and we will find out the z. Now this z value we will put in this formula. Okay. Wb, sigma b into z into wn square by 8. Here the unknown is l. So we will find the l here. Okay. Unknown is only one. This L is there, so we find out the L. Here L is coming number 851.59 mm. Okay, by using bending moment, our L is how much? 851.59. Now we will use the shear. By using the shear force, torque is equal to 12.5 V divided by BD. Okay, where V is equal to if the V one side and will transfer all the unknown thing in another side. Now V is equal to WL by 2. This is for simply supported. Again for simply supported, because we are using the simply supported beam or slab. That is WL by 2 V. So we will put this value V here and we will find out the L again. Okay. Because here the unknown is only L. So by using the shear force formula, we are getting L is equal to 1510.85 mm. This is the second L we got. Now we will use the deflection formula, that is WL 4 divided by 384 EI. Here all the thing is given in the question, only unknown thing is L. This value should be less than or equal to 1.6. Okay, so you can make is equal to, right, finding the L you have to take is equal to 1.6. Okay, is equal to 1.6. This whole formula, the unknown thing is only capital L, that is the spacing. Okay, so here L we are getting 551.97 mm. Out of all these three L, that is L from the bending moment, here we are getting L 851.59, for shear force 1510, and for deflection we are getting 551.97. Out of this is the lowest one. This is the lowest one. So we will take this L. Okay. Now we have to find out the spacing, that is center to center distance, that is center from this center to this center, we have to find out. Now we have got only the this internal portion, that is how much? 551.97. So we will add half portion of this joint. Half portion of this joint and half portion of this joint to the minus thickness of the sheet. Okay. The joint which is given in the question is size of 75 by 100. So here half of 75 means half of this and half of this. From this portion to this portion. So 5.0 plus 75 by 2 plus 75 by 2 minus 20 is the thickness of the decking, that is the thickness of the sheeting. So here we are getting 605 mm. Okay, so hence we have to provide the 600 mm spacing center to center of this